Hello there, my fellow knights and squires in arms. Ebon Knight here, and today I am bringing you part 21 of the Let's Play Jurassic World Evolution. And we're continuing where we left off, as per usual. Yeah, I got four centaurs here. I'm just going ahead and incubating this one for in case of Carnotaur, or Toro, as I have named them. Just named them that because, if I'm not mistaken, Toro is actually Latin for bull, which I believe is also still said to be in Spanish. I could be wrong, and by all means, if I am, just correct me in the comment section. We got new fossils, and I can tell that there's some glitch going on with the alarms in the park for when there's an emergency, which I need to fix that in a moment. Now, in the last video, I do want to point out that I did, well, at least you'll see it in the end when I get it uploaded, but I got so irritated with the stegosaurs that we had in this paddock here, and I just sat there and went, like, fuck it, I'm summoning you all, because they just would not stop trying to break out when all five of them were in here, and like a rebellious teenager is more or less how I would describe it. Anyway, management views for this area. Got that drink. I need to get a restaurant room. Somewhere. And shopping. Also a bit of a hide in there. So fossils on or gift shop will do. Actually a bar.
Attending to feeder supply. Acknowledged.
Right, I do not have a gate. So I completely forgot about that. Stick on here. Actually, it'd be better if I had just stuck it out over here. To be quite frank, I could have sworn that... Never mind. No.
You have a real eye for composition.
Watching
you work? Now that's what I call entertainment.
I've received an offer that will definitely help
Why do you want me to...
And can help you as well.
Yeah, like, that makes perfect sense. Hey, why don't you, sit here and... Why do you want me to build another power station? Right, I've not been a managing staff.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome the Centaurosaurus to the park.
Asset to be collected. Asset being transported.
And I'm just probably going to be destroying that here shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, find the perfect gift at our new souvenir shop.
Okay, the management views. Well, that seems to be good in this area now, so... Shouldn't be a big deal. Yeah, I got great satisfaction, great welfare, okay capacity, okay pride. Meaning,
good job on these new buildings.
To...
We have room to grow.
Thank you. One thing I will also point out that does kind of bother me a bit with the animations is that almost all of the carnivores in this game, they sit there and run with their tails dragging down, which I will point this out, that is rather incorrect, because for starters, the tail kind of acts as a bit of a counterbalance, especially for dinosaurs such as the Carno, because they basically sat there. Okay. I'm going to point this as to part of the reason as well. One, Carnotaurus, currently speculated to be the fastest dinosaur to have ever lived on land. And the reason for this is because it is estimated that his top speed clocked out at over 40 miles an hour. And typically, in this regard, what that would mean is that he would actually be running with his entire body streamlined. And speed-wise,
be a prehistoric cage fight.
He would actually be faster than the raptors. Decided to kill him as we surfaced him. Now, to be quite frank, I actually needed to check to see as to what would have been better in regards to dinosaurs that actually tolerated quite a bit.
On the asset.
Okay, that was nice now.
Treatment administered. Confirming asset.
And you're still running wide.
Gotcha.
Alrighty, now I'd like to know as to who's actually better in regards to population standards. Is it going to be the Pentaceratops, or is it going to be, like, say, the Styracosaur or the Somoceratops? That's fine. Yeah.
improving your stats in comparison to the Chasmosaur. Get Pentaceratops on the roll anyway, so for the science mission, so.
En route to collect the asset.
For now, new science contract, please.
I want to take this contract, which means you want to take it too, correct?
Don't let this opportunity pass you by.
If I were to take realism into account, that actually would not happen. The trick would have probably ran around trying to back up a leg. I'm gonna dig them horns in my ass. Because if that, I will point this out. Triceratops was actually charging in something such as a Carnotaur. Carnotaur would not want to mess with that. Because, real life, carnivores prefer to sit there and hunt something down that is actually easy to bring down. So, for example, sick or weakling or one of the young, not sit there and go for something that's in its prime.
The science division is a little stronger because of you. A little.
Hooray! Success rate 3.0. And one in there for the longest time. No, it looks like I'm going to be getting the Penta here soon. Which, however, the Pentaceratops in this game, in regards to size, is fairly accurate, but if I recall, it wasn't that much bigger in comparison to the trike.
New day, new show, new contract. Are definitely gonna want to check it out.
I'm getting to doing raptors here shortly. Once I come to think of it, I have not done this yet. Yes, to Melissa Gate. So that way we got Spino in the bigger paddock. Not wholly sure as to what they're panicking about. Alrighty, now to learn the social and the population caps for the Penta. This one has default skill. Okay, the Pentas need to go.
Acknowledged.
So if anything, these guys would have actually been better suited to stick in a small paddock with, say, Pachycephalosaurs, such as Pachycephalosaurs, Dracorex, or Stinky Moloch, and or with some Ankylosaurs. And to be quite frank right now, but the one thing I actually wouldn't mind losing, it'd be the Montessori. However, as of right now, currently, yes, see if there's not
adding task.
Another Ceratopsid that can tolerate bigger populations.
Request acknowledged.
Because, seriously, 11 dinosaurs in one paddock of this size, it's a bit small. I can easily stick in at least roughly 15 to about 18 dinosaurs in this one paddock. Without it looking too cluttered. Oh, and yeah, he actually killed the Montessori. Sit here and modify the genome even more because, well, gotta have a raptor with a rating of 116 released. Since he's going to be in there with the Carnotaur, I ain't going to sit there and let him, like, move his mind over this shit.
Collecting asset. Heading to collect the asset. Asset requiring collection.
So yeah, that was my phone in case that was ever picked up. Got a mic. All I got for you is Alpine and the wetlands.
Asset transportation underway.
Okay, now this leaves me with four centaurs. Or is it trike? And we get there. And it's still seven dinosaurs. These guys are gonna make my population for you guys is 22. 24 for Hippo, 16 for Trike, and Toro can tolerate 20. But since the Trike can only tolerate about 16, let's see as to how much a Styracosaur is going to get us. I'm actually a bit surprised that my Spino hasn't killed anything yet. And whenever you toss them into an enclosure, and I did learn this on my original saves, but if you sit there and I bring this up because I actually sat here and checked out the patch before I started recording. But apparently, whenever you stick a carnivore in with herbivores, ever since the update, they will not go for anything out of a live bait feeder. Instead, they will either kill and eat the herbivores that they kill normally, or they will go and eat out of a normal carnivore feeder, you know. I'm actually curious as to who might win this. Okay, you're at 40 health. Trike is sitting on 65. Nice change of pace of this fine. And the track's like, oh, I'm too injured. Fuck you. Alright, and he killed another centaur. Okay, I got some raptors.
Are what feed our attractions. That and goats. Lots and lots of goats.
The same skin, or you're Tundra and you're Alpine. Really don't look that different.
guess you're still gonna sit there and eat a rotten corpse. Alright, let's name you. Alright, now your population is 14. That's actually bad.
Please take cover until the condition.
Yay, I gotta get myself another Centaur.
Repair crew reporting in. Request acknowledged. Understood. Heading to pick up the asset.
An opportunity has presented itself.
I'm not gonna get an Ankylosaur because, for whatever reason, the Ankylosaurs can't tolerate that big of a population, which I will tell you this much right now. In a rather natural sense, this side of the paddock is the least occupied in comparison to the rest. So if anything, if I just sat here, stuck a feeder over here, and one Ankylosaur. The Ankylosaur would prefer to be over here and would only get stressed out by how big of the population is when I went over to get a drink. That's how it would pretty much go. Okie dokie, now. Two Strachosaurs trapped. Okay, by the time this Centaur comes out, it will be 11 dinosaurs in there. Think of what else I can stick in. Some Kentrosaurs are one of the Zithra, or for that matter, any other Stegosaur. I already have Kentrosaurs, and that's not going to be too great for my variety, so I got to sit here and stick in a different species of Stegosaur there. So, the Huayangosaurus, the Chinese one. If I recall, the Huayangosaur only requires roughly about 2 of its own species. That or one. Either or. I get lines of the carnivores who can't actually attack sauropods. Just hadrosaurs are about the loudest socializers in the game. I think I'm gonna give a Toro a friend, so... And hooray, Spinosaurus' DNA genome is fully mapped out.
Collecting asset. En route to collect the asset.
Where are the places where it gets to Rakasaur DNA? Any other location? There.
Now this contract is something special.
Yeah, too bad I don't have a Mammonkaiosaurus, nor do I. Correcting Sora's genome is not complete. This guy is more like a damn zebra.
Here's something that you might find interesting. I did.
Okie dokie. Time for another Kentrosaur. And I'm going to be ending this video here momentarily. Startups.
Acknowledged. Adding to the list. Confirmed.
Confirming task.
Trash out.
Sabotage resolved.
Hey, Keith. Us real quick. Alright. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please share amongst your friends to help get the word out on my channel. Really helps out a lot. Also, smash that like button. Or, if you didn't like the video too much, then by all means, feel free to put a dislike on it. Also, leave a comment, and for this particular series, leave a suggestion if you want me to do anything special with, if you want me to do anything special with the paddocks or enclosures, whatever you want to call them. Also, and subscribe for more. Also, feel free to check out my Patreon and become a patron yourselves to show your support and help this channel grow. Oh. After all, you are helping out quite a bit if you choose to do so. And I will see you guys in the next one on the battlefield. Peace out.